Now we move forward to the fourth case. We have two nodules, no comment, so two nodules in the left lobe. So let's see again with so this is the problematic nodule. I say tell you the final histological diagnosis. This proved to be a papillary cancer, and this one a benign hyperplastic nodule. Okay, before moving to this part, I present this. So the interpretation of such figures, such quite large, okay, this is dorsal to cystic area, but it is spared from these hyperechoic figures. Not the whole nodule presents such echogenic lines and granules. So we should consider in this case that this could be a microcalcification. So here and here we can see, and not on this part of the nodule. But this has also some cystic area, so I think that in this case microcalcification should be considered. It proved to be a benign nodule and had no calcifications, this nodule, but I think that is important. So have you questions regarding this nodule, the echogenic figures? I repeat myself once more. I don't think that a highly experienced ultrasonographer interpret these figures in the same way. I was absolutely not sure that this cannot be a microcalcification. Some of the colleagues might say that this is clearly a microcalcification. Others can state that this is clearly not a microcalcification. This is not an unequivocal example. But this case is presented for another reason, for the judgment of the echogenicity of the nodule. So I stop. As you know, to define whether a nodule is deeply or minimally moderately hypoechoic, we have to compare the echogenicity to that of the strap muscle. This histogram presents the grayscale distribution. The mean value of the grayscale was around 30. Smaller the number, darker the nodule. So this had a 30 pixel value. This nodule had a 20 value. So this is darker. We prove that this is darker than the strap muscle running ventral. So this should be regarded as a deeply or very hypoechoic nodule. In contrast to this, the smaller lesion, which proved to be papillary cancer, has a value of 37. The muscle had 30, so this is lighter than the strap muscle, so this should be regarded as minimally moderately hypoechoic nodule. Okay, it was a quite complex case because I tried to present this because of the discrimination between moderately and deeply hypoechoic nodules, but it had also relevance regarding these echogenic figures. Questions or comments to this case? No questions. Okay, then I stop the sharing, and before turning to the next case, I fix for myself the results of the previous poll. I have one comment. Less than 40% had watched the pre-recorded introductory video. I think for the next time it would be much better if more participants would watch these pre-recorded videos and read the manuals, because primarily for beginners, such conversations than this one had more relevance if you are quite prepared. And also, 40%, not 40%, only 11% had watched in advance these seven cases. I ask you that next time you will watch the pre-recorded cases, because it had more benefits for you if you don't see first time in the webinar these cases. No, but I have a second. Please.
Sorry. It means, may I have a question? Now
please.
I made something that I cannot please see anymore the screen. The question is, why did you make FNA to the small nodule, from the inferior pole of the lobe? That
okay,
has,
I go back. Okay.
What they were, I mean, it looks like to be below 1 centimeter. It has a round calcification, as I can see, without interruption. The nodule that is very down.
Okay.
Which were the criteria for
yes,
which you
yes
choose to make an FNA?
Yes.
Because it's
no, I understand. I try to answer it. So we speak about this, not this, about this nodule.
Yeah,
so,
yeah, yeah. It's below 1 centimeter.
Yes, yes, you have absolutely right. It has a discontinuous course calcification. So it had a capsule which was composed of coarse or macro calcifications, and here this is discontinued. This is one of the possible suspicious signs of malignancy of a papillary cancer, not a frequent one. So I thought that therefore I should aspirate this nodule. I do not surely follow the suggestions of the guidelines, and not necessarily follows even those who are the authors of these guidelines. Every guidelines speaks that between 5 and 10 millimeter FNA should be considered. In the main tables of all five target systems, they state that we have to make aspiration only in nodules larger than 1 centimeter, but in the text of all for all five guidelines, they write that we should consider FNA in lesions between 5 and 10 millimeters. So my answer is shortly that I could not exclude malignancy from this nodule, and it was 9 millimeter measured in histopathology, and a bit smaller in ultrasound. This is my answer, but again, this type of calcification or capsule, this was caused some concern, this presentation. Are you
okay
satisfied with my answer?
Yeah, I am. From my eyes, I would consider it discontinuous only in the inferior part, maybe with difficult way I would appreciate it that it's discontinuous. The macro calcification, the round macro calcification. I mean, okay, but of course it's about experience, and definitely you are right. This one is a question, and then May I?
Please.
So when you are making F&A in this module with macro calcification, with round-around macro calcification, is it possible not to go through the nodule because of the macro calcification?
Okay. Yes, you are right. In this case, it was not a thick macro calcification, but it occurs frequently that we do not succeed to gain material from how would you say, eggshell calcification when it is a very thick one. Occasionally, we do not succeed. But I think one stick have to be proved, have to tried, and I think that the diagnostic performance of cytology is much worse in coarsely calcified nodules, but it is not zero.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay.